Yes, consider the pre-void diagram. Either you can consider the FBD of the joint A, as here the unknown number members are only AD and AC. You cannot go to the joint C because unknown members are 1, 2, 3. You cannot go to the joint D because how many unknown members are there? 1, 2, 3. And you can go to the joint B because unknown members are. Right now you are having the two options. Either you can go to the joint A, then you decide where to go. Summary, if you want, I can tell you like this. First, if you go to the joint A, you will come to know what is the value of AD and AC. Next, if you go to the joint D, two unknown members are there, that is DC and DB. Or if you go to the joint B, two unknown members are there, that is, and if you go to the joint, means only initially, you cannot go for D and FC. Afterwards, you can go to them. What is the rule here? Whenever you are considering the FBD of any of the joint, maximum number of unknown member forces at that joint must be 2. If it is more than 2, you cannot attempt the problem. So I will start with the FBD of the joint D. Just see here how I am drawing the FBD of the joint C. It is not so big task. Whatever the joint B is there, the same joint I am picking, and imagine that I am cutting it here and taking it out like this. So the FBD of joint B, FBD of the joint B, right? So joint B, one vertical force is there, 666.66 newton. As I am cutting the member CB, the member force is coming into picture. The member CB is to the left of B, mark it to the left of CB, and here important is the direction. In whatever way he has given, you need to mark it here. But arrow, you can mark it in any way. You can mark the arrow either towards the right or towards the left, that won't matter. Mechanics will tell you in what way it may be afterwards, right? If your answer comes positive, means you assumed in right direction. If it is negative, your answer is correct, but direction is to be, you have to confess to the fact that yes, the right direction is not this, it is opposite to it. That is more than sufficient. But don't scratch the problem. It's all right. So the force FBC, I have imagined it like this. FBC, imagine it like this. Then FBD, here important thing is, what is the direction of FBD? FBD, here he has given this angle as 30. You need to make it as it is along that axis only. It is along the axis of that particular member. Axis of the member is 30. Only you need to mark along the axis. Direction, choice is left to you. You can mark it either towards the joint or away from the joint. Right? So this force, I am calling it as the FDB. See here in all, how many, you have drawn the pre-void diagram of this particular joint. You marked all the forces, external force plus the internal forces. This particular diagram is called as the pre-body diagram of that particular joint. Is it alright? Once if you draw the pre-void diagram, you can apply the equations of equilibrium to this one, and hence you can get the member forces. Yes, just see here. As this particular force is in vertical direction, FBC is in horizontal direction, only this force is not in vertical or horizontal direction. Bring first it in vertical and horizontal direction. Like this FDB, assumed like this, its vertical component is this one, and as this angle is 30, this will become sine of 30. FDB sine of 30. And here horizontal component will go like this. FDB cos of 30. Right? So, now you apply the equations of equilibrium. You have got the two equations of equilibrium for the joint. Total of vertical force equal to 0 and total of the horizontal forces is equal to 0. You decide yourself first which equation I select first. Just see here, if I take total of horizontal equal to 0, what I am going to get? like horizontal, I am having FDB going in horizontal direction, FBC also going in horizontal direction. Both are unknown to me. Hence, I may get the equation. Immediately, I may not get the solution. On the other hand, first if you go for Fy equal to 0, Fy equal to 0, total of the force in vertical direction is equal to 0. Two forces are there in vertical direction. One is 666.66 and one more is FDB sine of 30. Only two are there. Hence, apply the total of forces in vertical direction. Total of the forces in vertical direction Fy taken upward positive equal to 0. Yes, FDB is coming down. That is why it is negative. Minus FDB sine of 30. FDB sine of 30 plus 666.66 plus 666.66. No other force are there in vertical. Total must be equal to 0. Make the total equal to 0. What you are going to get? You will get the value of FDB. Solve it. You will get the value of FDB is equal to FDB BDRDB is equal to 133.32 newton. Check it. Yes, you got one member force. Luckily, friends, you are getting the positive answer. What it indicates, whatever direction you assumed there, that direction is giving you the correct direction of the force, is the meaning of that positive direction, right? So go for one more force, total of the force in one more equation, which is the left equation. Total of the forces in x direction must be equal to 0. Total of the forces in x direction, horizontal direction. How many forces are there in the horizontal direction? FBC, FDB. Is it all right? FBC and FDB. Is it all right? So make the total of vertical horizontal forces is equal to 0. Make the total of horizontal forces is equal to 0. One is FBC, which is going like this, is positive. And FDB cos of 30 plus is both are negative here. As I assumed like this is positive. FDB cos of 30 equal to 0. In this one, the value of FDB is known to you. Substitute it. You will get the value of FBC. If you solve this particular equation, you will get the value of FBC equal to, just solve it, minus 1154.69 newton. Friends, can you guess what this negative indicates? Your answer is correct, but direction whatever you have imagined is wrong. My kind suggestion, till you complete this particular joint, don't touch these answers. When you complete it, when you are going ahead, you confess yourself that whatever direction I assumed is wrong, is to be taken reverse in the further calculation. Otherwise, my member forces are correct. Then how I can rectify it? Just see here. FDB you assumed positive. Your arrow is going towards the joint. In your original structure, you mark the arrow towards the joint. And mark an arrow opposite to that particular arrow away from the joint. Are you getting what I want to say? Here it is towards the joint. Here also it should be towards the joint. As it is positive, assume direction is correct. And the value of that particular force is 1333.33. Just to avoid the confusion with the other numbers, you just round it, saying that I got that particular member. Next, you see here the one more member, BC. FBC. FBC is negative. How you assumed it? You assumed it towards the joint. Initially, you may not be knowing what may be the direction of the member forces. Simply, you are assuming, like you are not knowing the direction of the reactions. You are assuming if your answers are positive, direction of reaction is correct. If your answer is negative, direction of reverse is to be reversed. That That is what that you are doing. The same thing you need to do here. I assumed the force towards the joint, but I got it negative, means it should be away from the joint. That you rectify it here, which will be useful for you in the next problem. When near the joint, it is away from B. As you have assumed it towards the B, it is away from B. The same thing you mark it, the joint against it. So this member force and this member force are finalized. I am also mark here the number 1154.69. Yes, you got these two members forces. Now you go for the next joint. Your choice is, now you can go anywhere. You can go to the joint D because the two unknown member forces are there. And with one known force, you can go to the joint C because two unknown member forces are there with one known force and one external force. And you can go to the joint A also because there are two unknown member forces. But I will avoid to go to the joint D because all the members are inclined there. I need to cut all those members and bring them in X and Y direction. Better to go either to the joint C or to the joint E. Usually, I prefer to go from one end to the other end and I'll check whether I'm getting the right answer at the other end or not. That itself is a check of my problem whether it is correct or not. Is it alright? So, next I'll go to the pre-body diagram of the joint C. Friends, once again I'll repeat why you are going to the joint C now. You got it. Because there are three members at the joint C. Of that, already I got one. Two are left out. If two are there, I am having the two equations, hence I can find the solution to the problem. Yes, consider the FBD of the joint C. Joint C is here like this. You take all that diagram outside and apply the equations of equilibrium to it. Joint C is going like this. 1000 Newton is going downward direction. 1000 Newton is going down. Then here one member force, already we have calculated it and you have written here 11. Previously we have calculated it. I got it as 1154.66. Newton, and one member is inclined like this. I don't know the member force, but that member is the member CD, therefore I will call it as FCD. FCD or FDC, that won't matter here. Is it alright? That member is same member, FDC or FCD means. And one more member here is inclined, horizontal, is horizontal, and FCD is inclined at 60. You need to take care of this angle. If this angle, if you mark it different one, the whole problem goes wrong. Friends, one more thing you need to remember in case of the stress. This stress chapter is the easiest chapter for you. But my humble request, don't touch this particular question in the examination. Assuming that, yes, I got the problem. No, it consumes the maximum time. If you are finding a solution for all the questions which are known to you, and then if you won't have any other questions to solve, then only you can go for this one. Problem appears to be simple, but one small drawback with the problem is it consumes the time. You must be very perfect in getting the member forces. Then only you can go for this one. Otherwise, when you won't have any other questions to solve, that time you can go for this one. Indirectly, it will be a question for you to clear the subject, but you can't score better if you are not passed in calculating the member force. N number of methods are there in calculating the member forces. As you are in first year, it will be a bit difficult for you to get all those members. Yes, this is nothing but your FCD, and here one more member is there. As I told you, mark this arrow. Only it should be along this line, that is all. Either it is towards the joint or away from the joint, that won't matter. Yes, then you mark here one more force, that force is FAC. But here you can apply a little logic, like this force is going like this to balance this one, I am expecting it to like this only. So this is FAC. and this is the joint C. I consider the FBD of the joint C. FBD of joint C. Yes friends, 3 4s are in my line, X or Y line, only FCD is not in my line. And in this pre-boy diagram, how many unknown forces are there? Totally 4 forces are there. Out of that one, FAC and FCD is not known to me. So, I can solve it by applying the equations of equilibrium. First, you cut this FCD into two parts. One is in vertical direction, FCD. As this angle is 60, this will become sine of 60. And FCD cos of 60. Yes, you are having the two equations of equilibrium. From that, you get both the unknowns. But before applying anything, before writing anything, you just see the problem, how best I can attempt the problem like that. You are having the two equations. Total of the force in x direction must be equal to 0. And total of the force in y direction must be equal to 0. First, you apply total of force in x direction equal to 0. In that equation, you are having the two unknowns. FCD cos of 60 and FAC. Directly you won't get the, you will get an equation connecting FCD and FAC. Rather than that, if you go, first you go for the FY equal to 0, you are having only one unknown in the Y direction. That is nothing but FDC, FCD sine of 60. You apply it and get the value of that one. Then you can go for, yes, therefore, as the joint is in equilibrium, I got the right to apply the equations of equilibrium. Total of the forces in y direction is equal to 0. Total of the force in y direction taken upward positive equal to 0. Yes. So, what are the forces in y direction? One is going downward direction, minus 1000. And next force is going in the upward direction. Upward direction, therefore it is positive. What is that number? FCD sine of 60 plus FCD sine of 60. Total must be equal to 0. If you solve it, you will get the value of FCD. Solve it, just check it. You will get the value of FCD is equal to, you will get it as plus 1154.70. Check it, Newton. So I got one more member force. Yes, what is the left out equation? Now left out equation is the total of the forces in horizontal direction must be equal to 0. Total of the forces in horizontal direction taken towards the right equal to 0. See, what are the forces acting in horizontal direction? One is FAC minus FAC minus FCD. Already we know the FCD 1154.70. cos of 60 plus 1154.69 Newton, right? So only unknown is the value of FCD here, and solve for FCD, FAC, and you will get the value of FAC. You will get the value of FAC is equal to, yes, check it, 577.33. You will get the value of FAC. You will get the value of FAC. FAC equal to, yes, 577.33 Newton. Yes, I got two more member forces. One is FAC and one more is the FCD by considering the joint C. Luckily, I got both the forces as positive. What is the meaning of it? Assume directions are correct one. That is why my humble request is, if you are getting the negative answers, don't take the tension of it. If you take once the tension, if one more drawback of this particular chapter is, if you do the mistake in committing one joint, in calculating the member force in one joint, it will be carried throughout all the members. That is why I told you not to attempt this particular problem at the beginning. At the end only, you need to go for this particular model in the examination, in VTO exam, right? Or any exam. Stress appears to be simple one. Actually, it is simple, but it consumes the time. That is what its drawback is. Before going for the next joint, what we can do is, whatever the forces you have calculated, you mark them in the stress. Whatever the forces you have calculated, you mark them in the stress. Just see how you go for the joint, how you have assumed FAC. FAC you have assumed away from the joint here. From the joint C, you assumed it away from the joint. Mark it away from the joint. Next to the joint, at A, you mark it away from the joint. This job you need to do immediately, so that the errors can be minimized. And I got the value of FAC as 577.33, right? So round it to avoid the confusion with the other numbers. What else I got? I got the member force FCD. Just see here how I marked the member force FCD from C away from the joint. Mark it away from the joint from C, like this. From C you mark again, from D also it is away from the joint. What is that number you mark there? FCD 1154.70, round it. Yes. Now friends, only one member is left out with you. How many joints are there with you? Two joints are there, joint A and joint D. Means in all, how many equations are there with you? Four equations are there with you. How many unknowns are there? Only one unknown is there. Means three extra equations are there with you. From that you can check whether whatever problem you have solved is right or not. You indirectly, you only can evaluate whether your problem is correct or not. You need not wait for the examiner to evaluate it. Is it all right? Now, instead of going to the joint D, I'll go to the joint A and I'll show you how this problem is, whether the problem is correct or not. First, I'll draw this free body diagram of the joint A in the next page. Yes, FBD of joint A. FBD of the joint A. Yes, at the joint A, one vertical reaction is there. That vertical reaction is acting in the upward direction, 333.33 Newton. Next is one horizontal reaction is there. Reaction in the sense, the member force FAC is acting in the horizontal direction, 577.33. And only one unknown member force is there with me. Unknown member force, you can assume it in any direction, but little think over it. As this is going in upward direction, I'm expecting it to come in the downward direction. If it works, you do like that. Otherwise, you assume in any way, mechanics will tell you what is the right direction afterwards, right? That is what the beauty of mechanics means. If at all you are committing any mistake, as you are just in the first year of the engineering, you are growing. It's quite natural to do some mistakes. That is why excuse will be there for it. But that should not be repeated in future. Is it alright? So, go for this particular joint. I marked all the member forces. Even the horizontal force here is zero. I marked all the horizontal forces. All the forces here. Again, I need to go for the total of force in vertical and the horizontal direction. FAD is not in my line. That is why I will cut it into two parts, one in vertical direction, other in the horizontal direction. As this angle is 30 degree, this component will become FAD cos of 30, and this component will be FAD sine of 30. Is it all right? Now you go for, yes, now you go for solution of this particular. How many unknown member forces are there with you? Only one member force is there. How many equations are there with you? Two equations are there. So one additional equation is there to check whether you have solved the problem correctly or not. How I will tell you? First you go for either Rx equal to 0, Fx equal to 0 or Fy equal to 0. Total of the forces in x direction taken positive equal to 0. In x direction, mean the sense 577.33 is going towards the right. That is why I am taking it as positive plus 577.33 minus FAD cos of 30. Yes, therefore the value of FAD will become equal to, yes, what is the value of FAD? Tell me the value of FAD. FAD comes out to be 666.64 Newton. Friends, you want to check whether your problem is correct or not. Whatever additional equation is there, you apply here, and if you are getting the check, then your problem is correct. What is the left out equation? Total of the vertical force is equal to 0. Total of the vertical force equal to 0. How many force are there in vertical direction? One is plus 333.33 minus FAD. What is the value of FAD? 666.64 into sine of 30. Check, if it is 0, your problem is 100% correct. That itself is the check for the problem. Friends, one more thing you need to understand here. He has asked you to tabulate the results. So I can't write complete it in one page. That is why it will be a bit difficult for you to explain the things. Anyhow, you go for the original stress. Here I got the value of FAD is equal to 666.64, and I mark it towards the joint. Yes, and its value is 666.64 Newton. Yes, you got all the member force. Now he is asking you to tell him, tabulate the results, what amount of force is acting, what is the nature of the force. Just see here, if this is the member, this is the end. If I apply the tensile force from outside, how the inside forces will be? They are away from the joint. From the joint, this and this, you see here, they are away. This, I am calling it as the tension. If the arrows are going away from the joint, I am calling it as the tension, right? If you are applying, if you consider a member, if you are considering a member like this, if you are applying a compressive force on the member, you are applying a compressive force means you are applying the force on the member like this. What is the resistance in the member? If this is the end, inside the member, see how the resistances are developed. One force to this will be developed like this. You see that directions of the arrows inside, they are towards the joint. If they are towards the joint, you can take it as the compressive. And if you are applying the force like this, this force on the member, generally what you are calling it as the tensile force, then resistances, how they are developed in the member against this one. One resistance will be developed like this, other resistances, inside forces themselves, member force, we are calling it as the resistive forces. If they are away from the joint, we are calling it as the tensile resistance. Now, with your permission, in this small area, I will tabulate the result as the space is a limited one. Yes, just you have to tabulate the result like this. Member member then the pores, last is the nature. Yes, how many members are there? First member is say AD. Member AD. What is the magnitude of the force? 666.66 Newton. Whether that is towards the joint or away from the joint, they are towards the joint. Towards the joint, what I told you? Towards joint means compression. Nature, you write here compression. Like that, you write all the member forces. Next member force is AC. What is the member in the force in this particular member? The magnitude of the force is 577. 577.33 Newton. Yes, what is the nature of the force? It is away from the joint. Away from the joint, what I told you, it is tensile in nature. Yes, bit overlapping happens, otherwise I'll adjust the things here only. Yes, next member is DC. DC, what is the member force in it? 1154.7170. 1154.70. Yes, the forces are away from the joint. That is why in the bracket only I'll write here tension. You write in the next column. Yes, two more members are there. One is the member CB. Member CB. Yes, here also the member force is 1154.7 or 60, and this member force is also away from the joint, that is why it is tension. And last member is BD. BD member force is 1333.33, and towards the joint means you need to take it as the compression. Friends, it is best congested one. I'll clear the things in the next class. I hope you are comfortable with this particular class. And you practice the